Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. We all know TikTok has a bit of a bad habit of over-exaggerating the benefits of products and overhyping products that aren't really all that good. They also have a tendency to fake product claims as well. So what I want to do today is take five of the most viral skincare products around at the moment and just see if they're actually worth the hype. See if they actually do what they claim to do. So the first product is actually going to be makeup. And you know, I don't know anything about makeup, but this is something that I really want to talk about. And that is these kind of powders, these pore blurring powders that we've been seeing a lot of and how they just seem to instantly blur pores on your face. So to help me with this, I'd like to introduce you to Steph, if you don't know her already, who is going to test out one of these powders for us. So, Steph.
Hey guys, I'm Steph. Hello to James. I feel like we need to do like a little semi-formal introduction here. Should we like shake hands? Should we like, obviously because we're not together and I'm talking to myself right now, should we like pose for a photo and I'll Photoshop it and make it look like we're together? Like, aw. Oh, we're having such a great time together. Okay, so yeah, like James said, today I'm gonna be trying out the Rodial Glass Powder, which I have wanted to try out for a really, really long time. Number one, it's a bougie powder. I am very, very particular when it comes to loose powders, but the main reason I really wanted to try this out is because I've seen so many videos online, on TikTok, Instagram, everything, of this apparently blurring people's pores like into an oblivion. So there's one video in particular that I saw, hopefully you guys will be able to see that. But Lydia basically brushes over her skin with the powder and it does genuinely look like her pores are disappearing. And James and I were having this conversation because there's things to take into consideration. Like a lot of people instantly jump on that post and they're like tagging me, tagging James, and they're like, guys, do you think this is a filter? Do you think they've edited it? I'll be totally honest, I'm not sure if that video was edited at all. Like there's no cut, you don't really see an obvious blur. And I think one very important thing to remember is that not all videos that you see on your phone were filmed on a phone. Like I might film a video with this camera, which is in 4K, and by the time I've compressed it, it's not gonna look anywhere near as good as it would if it was on a TV compared to if it was on an iPhone. So I do think that is something to note. You know, maybe it was filmed on a higher spec camera and then as it's been shrunk down, maybe it's been sent to and from the brand. But even saying all of that, the video is still quite sharp. You can see her pores and there's no cuts and you can just see that it is blurring them away. So today I'm trying out the Rodial Glass Powder for myself, seeing how it works on my skin. And I'm gonna be showing you guys how everything looks on my 4K camera, on my macro. Those of you that watch my other videos will know that the macro is like a godsend. I mean, if you look at my skin right now, you can see it's very, very shiny. It's probably got some cat hairs on there, probably got like a bit of food somewhere on my face. But yeah, this camera, this macro, picks up everything. Like, if something happens on my skin, this is the camera that will show it. So I'm gonna put my very professional headband on because I'm very professional. So the foundation and concealer that I actually have on today is also from Rodial. I tried these out the other day with my normal powder and I actually really, really like the combination. This is the Soft Focus Effect Skin Lift Foundation. And then I also have the Diamond Concealer. I really, really like the foundation, just like a mini review there. And I'm just gonna make sure that my base is all sort of set. And if there's any cat hairs there, I'm just gonna push them further into my skin to make them look more seamless. So the way that a lot of people apply the powder is using a very small fluffy brush. So I'm just going in with this one. And just so you know, there's like no funny business going on here. I'm not gonna do any cuts. I'm just gonna go straight in around here. Already, I don't like what that's doing. I'm gonna get like, it's not pretty, but I'm gonna show you nice and close up. Do you guys kind of see? Like granted, I have got this scab thing on my face, but do you guys kind of see what's going on here? And I took the tiniest amount. Okay, I'm gonna do the other side. I'm doing the same sort of stroking motions. Oi, oi. So far, I'm not feeling it. This is a completely clean powder brush. And I'm gonna set it the way that I would the rest of my makeup. Just light little tapping motions. I think it's worth mentioning as well that I've never worked with Rodial. I don't get PR from them. I pay for everything that I got in today's video myself. And I think that looks quite nice. I mean, that's a pretty, this is quite a nice area of my skin. There's not really much going on, not really too much texture or any sort of like creasing. But I will say, that looks quite nice. It still looks quite healthy. It's got a nice sheen on the skin. But I feel like the biggest deal breaker with powders is how they look on your under eyes. So I'm taking that same brush that I used before, and I'm just gonna lightly pat on my under eyes. And I like to go from the outer corner inwards, because also there's a lot more movement as you kind of squint your eyes. You get a lot more movement, a lot more creasing around this part as opposed to this part of your eye. So I tend to focus more powder on the outer corner, just so it allows me to have a little bit more movement on the inner corner, because your girl's not getting any younger. It looks better than this little mess going on here. And it's still glowy. Being totally honest, the more that I look at it, now that it's settled onto my skin a bit more, I like how it looks on camera, but in person it does just look, I don't even really know. So that's good. Like, I put the tiniest amount on and it is sort of falling into my fine lines a little bit, like around my mouth, under my eyes. I definitely wouldn't say it's made my pores disappear. If anything, it's made this look a lot more textured. I'm very curious as to how things like bronzer and stuff will look on top. So I'm gonna take some of my Spectrum bronzer and just pop that over the top as well, because I want to see how it looks on top of the powder. Okay, cool. No issues with that. That's going on totally fine. So while I go and do the rest of my makeup off camera, I'm just going to insert a couple of clips of how my skin is looking, both in natural light on the macro. So yes, I'll see you guys in a second. I'm going to be looking a lot more cohesive and I'll let you know my final thoughts. Okay, so this is how my makeup is looking now. Everything applied really, really nicely over the top. And I do like the powder. Do I love it? No, I feel like the idea that it like gets rid of your pores, nothing. I cannot stress this enough. Nothing, not even like surgery, anything will actually get rid of your pores. Pores are there, they are useful. I feel like it bounces light off in a really nice way. Obviously I've got like tons of highlighter on right now, but just on the cheeks here, for example, I feel like it is really, really good at reflecting light. But does it make your pores invisible with just one swipe of the product? No. And I don't necessarily think it's down to like editing or anything like that. I actually don't really think that video was edited at all, at least not to alter the skin or with any filtering or anything like that. So in this case, I don't feel like we're being scammed or anything by any influencer or any brand or anything. I think it just comes down to compression and, you know, whatever camera or iPhone they used. But yeah, that's it from me. I don't really know how to end these sort of things because it's not like I'm ending a normal video. So I'm just gonna, should we do like a little handshake or a hug? Should we maybe like hug it out until the end? I'm gonna leave it here. I'm gonna leave you in the capable hands of James and hopefully see you guys soon. And make sure you like this video, subscribe, turn on notifications, do all the things. Because I love James. James is great. Okay, see you later. Off I go with my ears. Goodbye. I have nowhere to go. I'm gonna be sat here anyway, so. Okay, carry on with the video.
Thanks so much to Steph for doing this with me. Please check out her channel. All her information will be at the top of the description box. But yeah, here's the thing with these powders, they are supposed to blur your pores, right? So what I think this is, other than filters or possibly a mix of filters, is a mix of low camera quality, low upload quality, and the fact that when you are applying this powder, which is supposed to blur your pores, the camera can't pick up your pores. So it's doing this blurred effect, which makes the product look like it's this amazing pore blurring thing, when really your camera's just kind of like not picking up any details, it's blurring over it. But I do not think that this is how they look in real life. Your skin is not gonna look smudged. So moving on, let's go into the CeraVe Hydrating Foam Oil Cleanser. Trigger warning to those whose personality is only based around using CeraVe in their skincare routine. I do not like CeraVe. I find it boring. It doesn't work for my skin. That doesn't mean I'm not gonna give this a fair trial, but don't get heartbroken if I don't like this and you do. There's a cult around CeraVe and you all need to calm the fuck down. So initial impressions, I don't know too much about this product, but it looks like it's an oil cleanser, and not an oil cleanser in the sense that it will be your first step of your skincare routine and then you go into a second cleanse, but you can double cleanse with any cleanser, but more of a cleansing oil in the sense that it's not going to dry you out. So more of a cleanser with oil in it, you know? The main oil that they hype up in here is squalane, which we know is a great oil. It's not a greasy oil, very moisturizing. So hopefully this isn't gonna leave our skin feeling dry and cracked and punched. As with CeraVe, we have ceramides in here, a mix of ceramides, sodium hyaluronate, hyaluronic acid, I think as well, cholesterol, which is nice as well. It's CeraVe, all skin barrier healthy building stuff. Okay, I'm gonna go damp my face and I'll be back. Okay, damp skin. Okay, so already we can see it's not like an oil. It's not an oil cleanser. It's got that gel kind of consistency to it. And that's the thing, a lot of people are saying this is an oil cleanser. It's not, it's just a normal cleanser with oils in. I saw some people say that they weren't keen on the smell as well, but doesn't smell like anything. A little bit plasticky, but you know, that kind of smell you get when something isn't artificially fragranced, which I'm fine with. You know, it's not my preference, but this feels good. I could already feel it's not drying. It does feel like I'm rubbing a moisturizer kind of on my skin. It's got a very, very average gel cleanser consistency to it, but it's nice. I definitely didn't need to use that much. That was a lot going on there. A little bit seems to go a very, very long way, but most importantly, listen, cleansers are cleansers. They cleanse, they leave you dry, or they don't. So this review of this product is gonna take like 2 seconds, but I'm gonna go wash it off now and we'll see if it leaves me dry or not, I guess. Okay, Yeah, it's fine. I mean, my skin doesn't feel not dry, but it's not dehydrated, stripped, or anything like that. It's fine. It's fine. I mean, it's very similar to all the cleansers I use anyway. I feel like cleansers nowadays inherently don't want to leave your skin dry, so most of them don't do that, to be honest with you. Yeah, it's fine. I mean, I'm gonna use it. If you like CeraVe, you're gonna love this. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine, okay? CeraVe comes with a hype anyway. CeraVe is like, you know, everyone loves CeraVe. And that's fine. But if this wasn't, if this had a different brand on it, I don't know, like, I don't know, Neutrogena, I don't think anyone would be going that crazy over it. I'm kind of annoyed that I went out of my way to get it because it's not, it's definitely not worth going out of your way to buy. I mean, it's another cleanser to keep in the bathroom and try and use up. Yeah, it's fine. A lot of people are saying if you have dry skin, you're gonna love it. I don't necessarily think you, it's any different to an other cleansers you'll love if you have dry skin. You know, if you found the one you love, keep using that. This isn't really anything revolutionary. It's nice. It's fine. It's nice. Okay, next up, I need to apply a serum really quick because I am kind of defrosting something here, I guess, that you have to use your serum before. And this is the Charlotte Tilbury Cryo-Recovery Face Mask. Now, it says to leave in the freezer for a minimum of 30 minutes. Let me just double check that. Yeah, freeze for a minimum of 30 minutes. So I did that the moment I got this. I was kind of too excited because I wanted to try this. And it didn't go too well. So I vlogged a little bit of the first time I used it, and here's what happened. Okay, so do excuse the state of the background behind me. I just moved into a new house and I don't know what's going on yet. I'm not fully unpacked. So here we have it. This is the second time I'm using this. I got a little bit too excited when I first got it. I was like, right, I need to try this straight away. I wouldn't say it was a nice experience. I would actually say it was a little bit extreme for me, like extreme cold. These metal bits here hurt. They gave me brain freeze in an instant. It does feel nice, but it's just very it's very there. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's very, very cold. And it doesn't quite fit my face because things like this aren't really made for bigger faces. Especially when you have a double chin. So it kind of gives me this weird mouth like this. But it's not, I have to say, it's not enjoyable. There's nothing relaxing about it so far. It's actually somewhat painful. Ugh, and it's giving me brain freeze like instantly. And I feel like I can't relax. I have to like battle through this bit. And can we just talk about the packaging first of all? I don't know if this is something Charlotte Tilbury does, and I think it might actually be their thing, but it does look like vintage packaging in the sense that they try and put everything on the packaging, like everything it does, every claim. Every so often I just have to like lift it from my fingers, be like, oh my god. And after 10 minutes, okay, it's not as bad this time, but the first time I used it, my cheeks were very, very red, like very, oh, actually in real life, it looks a lot. If you wanna go out the light, you can kind of see it more. But it's really not an enjoyable experience for me. I think I'll keep it in the fridge instead of the freezer. And my skin does feel tighter. I don't know, I just kind of hurt. Okay, so now we're back. What I've done is I've kept this in the freezer, again, just for 30 minutes. So the other time I left it in there for maybe like 12 hours, 24 hours, I don't know, it was a long time. This time I left it for 30 minutes and I kind of let it sit here whilst I start filming and do this to try and just keep it more cooler than anything because I didn't really enjoy the original experience. And let's see if it's any less painful to use. As I said, I am a fan of cryotherapy, especially with rosacea. It's nice, kind of like just calming, soothing therapy for me. But it was a little intense. This is immediately already nicer. Like, I could probably keep this permanently in the fridge and just have it cooling. I don't know if it's something you get used to as you use it more and more, but I wish there was something on my nose, because really for me, the nose is the most porous area of my face. So yeah, let's leave this on for 10 minutes and I'll come back. And we'll see, I guess. I want glowing skin. And that's about it. That's all I expect from this glowy, temporary, tighter looking skin. We'll see.
Hi, it's me. Okay, let's go. Let's take this off.
It keeps cool for a very long time. I mean, during that 10 minutes, it doesn't feel like it gets any less cold, which I quite like.
Okay.
I mean, it feels dewier. Like, I'm looking in the mirror here and it looks brighter than it does on the camera. The thing is with my camera is it's on like auto, so it's gonna level things out to look the same. But you know what, it feels nice. It helps get rid of that redness usually. You know what, it feels nice. Usually when I use like my Fraser ice globes, or I've got like this Vanity Planet, Vanity Planet, are they still around? Little plate thing that makes it cold. It really helps calm my redness. And you can actually see it's dying down already now. I don't feel like it's worth, honestly, the money. I feel like there's many other cold things you can put on your face. You could put a cold sheet mask on your face and probably do the same thing. I don't feel that, like, there's a whole ton of benefit to those little kind of like acupuncture points that you get there. For me personally, you could buy this kind of silicone-y beady part. You could buy masks on Amazon that are made completely just from that you can keep in the fridge or freezer. It does the same thing. So their claims are skin feels instantly firmer. I've had filler, so I don't know. Skin feels instantly smoother. It does feel smooth, I must say, but that's probably down to my serum and face wash. Skin feels instantly revived. Yeah, I guess. I feel fresher for sure. Pores appear instantly tighter and more refined. Honestly, I take quite good care of my pores, so I couldn't really tell. Skin looks younger. I don't know. How young do I look? Skin looks glowing. It does give me a very nice glow. It feels cooling on acupressure points. Okay, that's just a fact. They're just telling me that. I mean, they also say with clinical trials that over time, skin felt firmer. Skin feels lifted by 253%, feels firmer by 238%, smoother by 243%. I'd love to know. Puffiness around the eyes area is reduced, which I don't get because none of it touches your under eyes. So it could be because it's made for smaller faces, but on me, if you put it straight on, it kind of like misses. Like, if I'm going to put this on, it just misses. It goes just under here, and I get puffy like right under here. So I don't know, I can't really tell the difference. I mean, sure, you know what? It feels good, it makes me look glowy after. Over time, is it gonna make me feel more lifted? I don't believe the science is there to say that applying cool stuff to your skin changes the structure of your face or helps tighten skin. Is it £49 worth of nice? No. I'll put a cheap Amazon mask down below and you can just get that. It's the same thing. I must admit, the straps and the way it's fitted, especially on the chin, feels nice, but I don't think it's worth that much money. Okay, let's move on to one that really is, I struggle with this. I'm so sorry. So this is the Caudalie Instant Detox Mask. This is kind of like the repackaged, reformulated version of this extremely viral clay mask. It's just the clay mask. I've not even used it yet, but I'm telling you now, it's just the clay mask. So when we look at the ingredient list, there's nothing really in here that sets it aside from other fancier clay masks. We have the very, very usual clay mask ingredients. So we have bentonite clay in here, which is bentonite clay. It's in every clay mask, right? Then we have some essential oils. So again, like clay masks, it says it draws out impurities. And that's the claim, is that this mask dries out on your skin. And you see all the little holes on your nose and on areas of your face where it's drawn out all the dirt and oils and all that kind of stuff. That's not how clay works. Clay works by absorbing, so it has to be touching something. It's not like a magnet. It can't draw something out that it's not touching, right? It says here that pink clay purges pores of blackhead causing dirt and excess oils. Papaya enzymes brighten and invigorate, and grape exhibits powerful detoxifying properties, which is true. Grape is a great antioxidant. Okay, so let's have a look at some of the TikToks. Probably some of the most popular about this clay mask and its repackaged, reformulated version.
Caudalie have come out with a new version, so I wanted to show you how it absorbs excess oil and leaves your skin looking really fresh. On the side with no product, it doesn't look like there's much gunk on the skin, but you can see the mask has pulled out all the excess oil that was hiding in my pores. Follow for part two.
So this is a perfect example. Actually, we'll come back to that one.
What? Are you guys seeing this? Did somebody say viral detox mask? Well, it's back, but with a new look, but the same formula. So I'm really excited to use this mask. I've never used it before, but I love Caudalie products. It's meant to eliminate any kind of impurities in the skin, draw out excess sebum, but also tighten the pores as well. So it says to leave on for 5 to 10 minutes. Let's see the magic work. I'm 7 minutes in, literally can't even talk. But are you guys seeing this? Okay, time to wash this off. So I'm back, I'm all rinsed off, and let me tell you, my skin feels incredible, guys. This did not go viral for no reason. You need to check this out.
She looks incredible, but let's go back to that first video and take a look at the pores. So if we look at the before and after side, you can see her pores on the before side. You can see them on her cheeks, right? And then they're there in the exact same place where the clay mask is. This isn't because her pores there are full of impurities or excess sebum or oil. This is just how clay masks sit on top of pores. If you don't regularly do things like exfoliate or look after your pores, this is how your pores are gonna look under a clay mask. In fact, right, if you Google clay mask pores, here are some of the pictures that come up. This one is from a Laneige mask, water clay mask. Looks exactly the same. This one is just from a general clay mask. I can't remember what clay mask that one's from, but there we go, another clay mask. Looks like the Laneige one again. This is a L'Oreal mask. Again, looks exactly the same. Another face mask. All these clay masks look the same because that's just how they dry out on the skin. It's nothing that this product is doing that's any different to another clay mask. Now, I must say, I got a brush to put this on. I already really like the texture of this and the fact that it's a clay mask that comes in a tube. Often they come in, they do come in a tube, but they'll come in like a pot and it's all a bit kind of like DIY feeling, kind of feel to it, you know? But this is almost like a really creamy moisturizer. And I must say, I do like the texture of it. This one is £23. The smell is quite overpowering. I must say, you can really smell those essential oils. Be wary if you're usually allergic or get irritated by them. So we're gonna let this dry on my skin for 10 minutes, right? My nose, of course, is the area where you are gonna see more pores because that's my most porous area. My cheeks, maybe not, I don't know. We might be surprised, but those little dark spots you see, there may be like sebum that's on top of the skin and sitting in the pores, but it's not dirt and gunk that is pulled out from the pores. Already, I do like this as a basic clay mask. It's nice, it feels good on the skin, it goes on easily. It'll be interesting to see how it dries out because the only other clay mask that I've liked recently is the Glow Recipe whipped one because it doesn't dry out on the skin. So let's see how it goes. Okay, so it's drying out, but we can see it's showing up pretty much every pore I have on my nose. A lot more than I thought it was gonna do, I have to be honest. I thought my pores were gonna be smaller than that, but this isn't anything out of the ordinary. This is just sometimes how a clay mask is gonna dry on your nose. I mean, it's a clay mask. Decently priced, I feel, you know. Some nice ingredients as well. I don't think it's the worst. I think it's overhyped for sure. So this clay mask is going viral for pulling stuff out of your pores, and you're meant to, all this is supposedly the gunk, but it's not. And it doesn't really say it works that way. And whilst all clay masks do claim that it's pulling stuff from your skin, it doesn't say that you can see the gunk on top of your skin or that, you know, there's any, in fact, you can see that they're just, oh, that's making me feel sick. You can see that they're just holes. They're just holes. Like, they're not even sitting on the pores. That's making me feel ill. Yeah, you can literally feel, like, the ridges. It's not sitting on top of the pores where it's supposed to be drawing stuff out from. It's just holes. In my case, and in other cases, it's just surface oils, which is
normal. It's not pulling stuff out. I need to wash this off. It's making me feel ill. Unfortunately, dry is very hard, and that's what I don't like about clay masks. I'm now going to have to go, like, scrub it off. Okay, two things now it's off. My skin feels extremely dry. It looks very shiny and even, but my skin feels so dry. I'm going to put some moisture back in it also. I can, as I started washing off, it kind of matches the color of my skin, so I couldn't see if it was completely off. It was kind of a nightmare to wash off, but the next product is going to be the L'Oreal Magic Skin Beautifier Anti-Redness. It's a BB cream, which is makeup, right? So whilst I rehydrate my skin, let's have a look at some TikToks, because they're everywhere. I'm not on makeup TikTok, I'm on skincare TikTok, and I still see this everywhere. So I want to have a look at what this product's supposed to do and some of its claims, and see if it works on me, because I have some visible redness whilst I rehydrate myself. That looked good.
Let's try out a green color-changing BB cream. Anyway, she is from L'Oreal, and it supposedly cancels out any redness while turning into your perfect match. Holy shit, do you see that? Where did it go? Wow, I'm into this. It's like your skin, but better.
That was a more realistic demonstration, I feel. I know that that person is kind of known for their more real videos. Like, I get tagged in a lot of their videos asking if they're using a filter, and he's not.
Let's try her on. Oh my gosh. 10 out of 10, do recommend, girl.
Okay, she says 10 out of 10. Do recommend, girl. So let's have a look. I'm a little bit nervous. I'm not going to use as much as they do, because if I've learned anything from my brother's videos, is that you don't need that much. Oh, it's a lot more liquidy than I thought it was going to be. Oh, there's so much. So BB cream, I think it stands for blemish balm. Let me know if I'm wrong. But again, I think it's something that stems from Asian countries again, so I won't put it here. You can definitely see where it is. I mean, like, it's not interesting. Like, it's actually orange on my hand. You can see it's like orange there. It's weird because I feel like it's going on my skin and turning into a color that doesn't necessarily match. Like, you can see bits of orange. I feel like it's just making me more paler than anything. I mean, really, BB creams you can use alone. Like, they're not meant to be like a base layer or anything. You are meant to be able to just use it on its own as its own layer. I think you can really see it on my nose, right? You can see the before and after, but it does have this slight orangeness to it that makes it look like I've used fake tan and I washed it off, but it's not all come off. So we have it like in the corner here. Is a little bit up here and in my hairline around here especially as well. Maybe that's where it's gathered up too much. I don't know. I feel like it's just made me more pale. I don't know. Here it kind of, you can't really see. On the nose, I feel like you could really see it, right? I don't know. What do you think? Like, I still feel like I look really red here. And then I like the same here. The nose, right, hang on. Right, remember how red it is here, right? Okay, this is the worst demonstration. I panic when it's anything slightly makeup related. Look, it's orange here again. Look, it definitely evens out my skin tone. Should I have applied this with like a brush or a beauty sponge? I have no fucking clue. You should just be able to apply this with your fingers. It's all this, like this orangey hue you can see on my fingers here is what I can see on my face, which is kind of annoying. A bit crusty as well. I don't know. I don't. What do you think? I don't know. I honestly have no idea if that's done anything. I feel like at first it looks really, really pale and really light. And the more I look at it now, the more it has a chance to sit on my skin. I'm like, is it going already? I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comments.
Also, let me know if there are any other viral TikTok products that you would like me to try. Don't forget to go and follow Steph as well. Thank you so much to Steph for helping me out on today's video. You can watch some more TikTok-related videos here and some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.